وتقدير لشخصية الحقيقة شخصية ناجحة جدا على مستويات كتير جدا، المستوى الإنساني والاجتماعي، وطبعا قصة نجاح عظيمة في البيزنس. بدأ كرائد أعماله النهاردة، إحنا يعني هو مثل أعلى لشباب كتير نفسهم يحققوا حلمهم. النائب محمد أبو العنين، دعونا نرحب بالأستاذة سمية أبو العنين، نائب رئيس مجلس إدارة مجموعة شركات كيلو باترا ونائب مؤسسة أبو العنين، والأستاذة هبة شبانة حرم النائب محمد أبو العنين لتلقي كلمة وتتسلم بالتكريم. مساء الخير، برحب بالسادة الحضور، وأنا حاضرة النهاردة نيابة عن السيد محمد أبو العنين وكيل مجلس النواب، وهو بيعتذر لظروف طارئة ظهرت فجأة فاضطر إنه ما يقدرش يجي ويشاركنا النهاردة الاحتفالية العظيمة. واسمحوا لي أنا هكمل بقية الكلمة بتاعتي باللغة الإنجليزية بما إننا في مبادرة دولية وحابين إنه الرسائل بتاعتنا توصل بوضوح للمجتمع الدولي اللي حاضر معانا وبيرعى المبادرة دي. Dear guests, I'd like to welcome you all. I'd like to welcome your excellencies to Egypt, the land of peace, the land of hope, the land of culture, the land of civilization. Throughout history, Egypt has played a great role in creating peace, in spreading culture, in spreading hope in the region. And today, again, we're very happy that Egypt is sharing and this initiative for Hope Givers, another global initiative that we're happy to support, and we're happy that it's being hosted here in our capital city, Cairo. And it is a source of happiness and pride that that there is such an international association and initiative that shares and celebrates humanity, inspiring stories, initiatives, actions, foundations across the globe and in every corner of the world, sharing human stories that spark life and hope. And as a woman, I need to say that every woman around the corner in every part of the world is the true spark of hope. She gives birth to hope. She nurtures hope. And we see it in a very agonizing reality with the women of Gaza. Every day, the women of Gaza, they need to heal the physical and emotional wounds of her children, her shattered family, trying to give the spark of hope, nurture hope that there is a better tomorrow that has justice, a better tomorrow that has hope, a better tomorrow that has humanity. And I would like to take this chance that we all gear up and stand together under the umbrella of Givers of Hope to raise and awaken the global consciousness of what's happening in Gaza, with all the lack of humanity and the very severe conditions that the people are facing in specific, and actually to each and every country in the world that's facing similar reactions. Here, under the umbrella of Givers of Hope, we raise the flag of hope, we nurture the hopes and the dreams of children for a better tomorrow, a better future, a better world. So let's all stand for this. Stand for Gaza, stand for the injustice and the inhumanity that Gaza is facing every day. And today, as I represent my country, Egypt, I would like to highlight one of the biggest charity initiatives, one of the biggest, I would say, in the region, if not in the world, that is taken under the vision and the leadership of His Excellency President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, the National Alliance for Charitable Work. This association is founded and supported by the vision of our president. It has become a model for charity, for sustainable development for more than 30 million beneficiary annually, supporting basic needs that include shelter, food security, health, and education. Our president has become an icon of hope, and I would even take it further, translating hope into reality, a vivid reality that everyone is living from our less fortunate segments of the community. He has become an icon that gives a dream for a better future. He makes us, as a mother, more comfortable, more happy, more positive about the future of my children under the vision of his Excellency. Women under his leadership has taken unsurpassed opportunities. They have occupied leadership positions in ministry cabinets, in the parliament, in several key leadership positions in the government. So goes and follows the private sector and the civil segment. This is not only a sign of empowerment, but it's a sign of a global leader with a global vision to actual sustainability and growth and prosperity. Following the vision of His Excellency is Abu Al-Ainain Foundation. Allow me to give you a short brief in a nutshell about the foundation. The foundation was founded more than four decades ago with more than 1 million beneficiaries, focusing on three main pillars: education, women empowerment, youth empowerment, through several protocols and programs that we run that educate, that provide training, that provide e-commerce platform so that people do not live on charities, rather than they become breadwinners with skill sets that they acquire so they can compete, they can offer a better life for themselves, for their families, and eventually become a better country and a better world. Our founder and chairman, Mr. Abu Al-Ainain, has instituted charity and sustainable development within the DNA of each and every family member, of each and every member of the company. To him, this is something that is not only an obligation, it's a decision that we make every day and a commitment that we need to have towards our smaller communities and our country at large to become a better country and eventually a better world. Again, I'm greatly honored to be among all of you today, and I look forward that we keep on hosting more international collaborations, raising the flag of hope, the flag of translating hope to sustainable actions for all the less fortunate people, whether they are diseased people or economically not at privileges like other segments of the society. Thank you so much, and I'm greatly honored to be with you. أشكركم جميعا.
النهارده عايزين نكرم سمية كل اللي انت عملتيه في الانجازات والاعمال الخيريه كتير اللي عملتيها، فده تكريم ليكي على كل حاجه انت عملتيها، ولينا الشرف بوجودك النهارده وبنشكرك جدا جدا بوجودك النهارده. لا بجد والله احنا اللي متشرفين جدا وبهنا.